Right, so Sam Nicholson is trying to do the rules and regulations of rugby leagues. He's task one for rules and regulations, unit 22. Right, where are you going?
Summary of the rugby league with the rules. The objective of the game is to score as many points as you can and beat your opponent. Each team has six tackles to try and score at the team's end of the field. If there's six tackles, you have to score a try, turnover happens, and the other team gets the ball where you got tackled. The same thing goes for that team. The game consists of two halves that are 40 minutes long. Beginning of the game, the coin is tossed to decide which team gets to kick the ball, which one receives the ball. The other team that doesn't get to pick, gets to pick which side of the field they want to play on first. After it's decided, the players take the place and kick off on the air with the ball. At the end of the 40 minutes, a hooter or alarm on the faction is set off by a timekeeper, not a referee. It's a signal in the app. That will then end either a dead ball, which is going to touch, or a tackle. If there's a penalty, the penalty will be allowed to be played, and then after that, it will be the next tackle, but there's a stop to play in the app or in the game. If the game's tied, it will end as a draw. If it's a league game, or if there was a such as a grand final game where there has to be a winner, it will go into extra time. And if nobody scores in extra time, it goes to the golden point rule where the game doesn't end until one team scores a point. Laws of the game by the IFL. There are 13 players on each side, 40 minutes a half, and then timekeeper on the pitch gives a clock of time to signal the game's over. A try worth 4 points, and then you get a chance to go to a conversion, which is worth another 2 points if you get the kick. You also have a drop goal, which is worth 1 point, which comes up at any time during the game, and a penalty, which is if you get fouled, you can go for 2 or come up for a tap and get over 6 tackles. The ball has to be passed backward, it can pass as many times as you like, as long as it is passed backwards. If you pass forwards, it's the team's ball, it switches possession. Each team gets 6 tackles. After a tackle, you do have to play the ball backwards by rolling with your foot. If you don't roll it backwards, if it goes forward, it's counted as a knock-on, and your team gets the ball again. 6 players for a knock-on on a forward pass is also a scrum, where 6 players go to a scrum. It's good for resetting the game instead of just a tap, as it's better for attacking opportunities. If you get back 10 yards every tackle from where the tackle is played, where the ball is played, if you're in front of the referee and that you're counted as offside, if you get involved in the game, you get penalised, and the other team gets 10 yards penalised. A 40-20 kick can be played when you're attacking. If you kick the ball before your 40-metre line and get it after their 20-metre line, and with it bouncing, it does not go out on the ball, you then get to play the ball on, tap the ball on the 20-metre line. This goes because it's sort of, don't have to wait for the referee to get all the players back. You can just tap it as and when you want, as long as you don't pass the ball to another player and bring the ball back in the 27. Rugby league match, rugby league pitch is 100 metres, no more than 100 metres in length, not including the in-goal touch areas. No more than 68 metres in width, and it's marked every 10 metres from the line to let the referees know where to play the ball, how for penalties and stuff like that, how far to get back, so he's not doing 5 yards here or 15 yards back, and then they'll fail the offside rule. Touchline is marked out so the touch judges and the referee know if someone's going to touch. The sticks are the same size on both sides of the pitch to make the game unfair, so it's not smaller on one side and harder to get a goal on one side of it as the other. It's played on a grass pitch with less injuries and people getting tackled, it allows for more cricket play boots on a rough play boots. Lets them get away quickly and pick up the pace of the game. The main role of the referee is to take control of the game and make sure all the rules and laws are followed throughout it. The main referee will be part of the field competition, he's on the field to make decisions so he gets a better view of the game. He makes decisions for what he sees fit and he has the power to stop or start a game or time to account for additional time. If players are breaking the rules, he has to punish them as he sees fit, so he could be breaking from a penalised tackle where he get up the field a bit for 10 yards, or it could be a red card if it was a brawl on the pitch or something like that. The controls are aspects of the game, such as kicking off, ending the game, restarting.